just say what this year maybe has meant to you, how God has blessed you. And I know that we've had some tragedies this year, some deaths continue to come our way. But I'm grateful to the Lord for another year of life. I'm grateful for another year with my wife. Boy, that rhymes. But God's been good to our family.
Amen. Amen.
Well, can nobody do me like Jesus? Well, can
nobody do me like the Lord? Well, can nobody do me like Jesus? He's my friend.
I said there can't nobody
do me like Jesus. Well, can
so true.
Yes.
Ain't nobody
yes.
do me like Jesus.
That's right.
I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord.
I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Of our praise. If we ask Him, He'll save. Let us rejoice that Jesus is in the house today.
Well, let us rejoice.
Oh, let's rejoice
that Jesus is in the house.
Let us rejoice.
Rejoice that Jesus is in the house today.
Well, the anointing is upon us. We will never be the same.
Oh, the demons cannot stand it.
You know they tremble at His name.
Let us rejoice
that Jesus is in the house.
Let us rejoice.
Oh, let us rejoice.
You know He's walking up and down the aisle.
He dwells in the presence of our praise.
If we ask Him, heal and save.
Let us rejoice that Jesus is in the house today.
Well, the anointing is upon us.
We will never be the same.
Oh, the demons cannot stand it.
You know they tremble at His name.
Let us rejoice.
Well, Jesus is in the house.
Let us rejoice.
Oh, let us rejoice.
You know He's walking up and down the aisle.
Well,
He dwells in the presence of our praise.
If we ask Him, heal and save.
Let us rejoice that Jesus is in the.
Let us rejoice that Jesus is in the.
Let us rejoice that Jesus is in the house today.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Try singing and playing it at the same time. Praise the Lord. And I remember Dean Smith when he was here, he played the bass guitar, and he's done such a wonderful job on teaching us this song. And and so many years, people, you know, they go, well, I'm rejoicing because Jesus is in the house. But we've learned that Jesus is not in the house, but He's in the house.
Yes.
He lives inside of us. And I'm grateful that, and I rejoice in knowing that He lives inside of me.
Amen.
And I pray that if He doesn't live inside of you, you need to let Him in. Mm-hmm. You know, He stands at the door and knocks, and He said, if you'll open the door, I will come in and sup with you and you with me. And, you know, as I was reminded again of our mortality this week, I did a funeral for a lady that used to attend here, and was one of those ladies that was a great help to us when she was here. We used to have ministry there in the Cass Corner and Cass Park, and she couldn't go because she was older. She just couldn't stand the cold in the wintertime when we would go out there. But she would make boxes full of cookies. Mm-hmm. I mean, just box after box, and she'd bring them here. And her and Sister Sharp, and not all of their stuff always made it to Cass. I mean, you know, most of it did, but, you know, we'd have a bite here or a bite there while we were here or on our way down there. And it was... she was such a blessing in this house, and just to be able to go and just honor her and talk about her at the funeral this week was a blessing for me. And she's home with Jesus.
Amen.
She's done with this side. And one day we'll all be over there.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. And we have, what this song says, we have that blessed assurance because Jesus is mine. He lives in our heart. He lives in our life. So we got nothing to worry about.
That's right.
You know, I remember Jim Batch used to say, heaven's a gimme. Now that I've accepted Jesus Christ, I'm going to say it's a gimme. So I'm just going to be busy about the Lord's business until He decides that it's time for me
come
home.
Amen.
And so let's just stay busy for the Lord. As I told the men at the men's breakfast we had yesterday, we have to endure to the end. Mm-hmm. We have to keep going. You don't stop just because you got, you know, 3/4 of the way down the road. We just keep following and keep going forward. And one of these days we'll cross over into that beautiful land that Jesus said, I go to prepare for you. So we look forward to that day. And it's not so much a planet or a It's a dimension. It's a place where we move from here into that realm. And I don't know if they can see us, but, you know, Pastor Chris and I were talking yesterday. There's a song that I would love to be able to do, but I can't find any soundtracks for it. But it's called Voices from the Other Side. And sometimes I wonder if they're not screaming, keep going. That's right. Don't quit. It'll be worth it. You can't wait till you see this place. And so just keep enduring to the end.
Amen.
The scripture says, and the same shall be saved.
Amen. Amen.
The song says, blessed assurance. Sing it with me, all right? Blessed assurance. Jesus is Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Be seated. I'm going to ask everybody to sing, so I'm going to maybe skip a song this morning. Get to them. Sandy's coming, so you pray for her as she comes, all right?
You pray for me as I do this first song. I haven't done this one in, I can't even tell you how long. It's been a long time. But I got up this morning and I did my devotionals. And as I was doing my devotionals, I looked over the calendar to see which one I was supposed to do. And I said, oh, this is the last. This is New Year's Eve. This is the very last day of 2017. And I thought, this song was on my heart when I got up this morning. And I thought, what an appropriate song. And it's, He'll Do It Again. And you know, if you look over your life in 2017, I know I've done it. And I've seen a lot of tragedy. We have lost a lot of people that we know. But as far as I know, all of them are with Jesus. So that's a joyous thing. But I says, you know, I know that God has done so much for me. For my family, it would take me a lifetime just to tell you all the prayers that he's answered and things that he's done. And I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. And I said, and when he does it in the past, that means he'll do it again. And so I'm looking forward to 2018. I'm looking forward to good things happening. I'm already in expectation of the good things. And I said, that's what you, when you pray for something, that's where you have to be. You have to be in this expectation. And the enemy tries to take it away from you. He did me with all this sickness we had here recently. But I said, you know what? I said, God is so good. And I said, he puts it right back there. And I noticed it yesterday. I said, I had such an excitement in me. And I said, oh, Lord, you brought it back to me. I said, that expectation of something good is going to happen. And I said, when you look for that, and you pray and you believe that God will do what he says he will do in his word, I said, if he done something for you last year, and I know he did because you're sitting here looking at me breathing. And I said, that's a pretty good deal right there. I said, you're walking around, you're breathing, you got a smile on your face. And I said, and he'll do the same thing next year for you. Just ask him and expect it. So you pray for me as I do this song.
Broken into. Oh, but he's a God of the stars.
Otherwise, me and my daughter wouldn't got food poisoning. And I said, suffered with all that. But I said, you know, I said, no matter what we go through, I like this next song. Because I said, no matter what you're going through, try your best to praise Him. I try my best to praise Him. Even in the sad moments, the dull moments, the everything that you're going through, I try to praise Him. Because I know that I have prayers I want answered. And I said, I don't want there to be a moment that me and God is separated. I don't want there to be a moment that there is. And I said, sometimes when you get sick or down or depressed or whatever, sometimes that happens. It does happen. But, you know, just try to get a devotional, read it. Get a verse in the Bible, read it. Something you can stand on. God is true to His Word. Praise God.
Seems so tall, and you realize Thank you.
See, you're all getting a smile. What's wrong with that?
It's comedy hour. We're getting more success.
No. I was waiting for you to say something.
Oh, I already talked.
You already talked? Okay. It's okay to talk again. We don't get to do this song very often, so we're going to do it one more time.
I love this song. Oh, I love this song.
Hallelujah. I feel His presence today. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. Shout something. After all these songs and all that we've been feeling, surely got to give Him some glory in the house. Amen. Amen. This song, I don't know if I've ever sang it at church, but it's a biblical, the words. You know, it was about someone that was lost and found and blind and dead. But really, that's who I was, and that's who you were before we came to know Jesus Christ. And that's what this song is about. Setting me free, setting us free. Amen. Hallelujah. That's the story of all of us that didn't know Jesus and how he found us. And we were dead, the Bible says, in our trespasses and sins. And whew, hallelujah. We're alive in God. Aren't you glad? Aren't you happy and so blessed? Man, I love singing that song. I sing it too often, but I don't know. Sometimes when I'm singing songs, I try to. It seems like I feel after a song that I can feel in my heart. You know what I'm saying? And although all those songs that everyone sang this morning, I could have sang or tried. I felt every one of them, haven't you? I'm going to try a song this morning. I'm going to try to plug me in here. I've never done this song before. And really haven't practiced it a whole lot. Kind of until this morning, and we'll see what happens here, if I can find it. I've just been a place where I've kind of been this week, and I'm thankful, and I've been hearing the Lord just, I don't know, you ever feel the Holy Spirit just spooling you and drawing you, and just, you know, just making that time, and He allows you to, I'm so grateful for time that He allows, you know. And, you know, when you're working and you're busy and you're, you know, I'm not making excuses, but sometimes you get busy with everything and you for a while you crave being with Him, and then after a while you just feel like, I got to try to fit Him in. And there comes those seasons and times where maybe God will slow you down or give you a little time to where you can just reconnect, you know. And I heard Him telling me that the other day. It's like, Chris, this is the time that I want to kind of reconnect with you, amen. And I'm so glad He's always waiting, amen. He's always waiting for me to do my part, because He's always ready, you know. God's always ready. He's always wanting to fill us and speak to our hearts. I'm going to try to do this. See what happens. You're going to have to do the volume here, I think.
You're all
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love that song.
I do too.
I feel His presence, don't you today?
Yeah.
Man.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor. I'm going to get me one of these. Oh, I already have one. Just don't know how to use it. Praise the Lord. It's such a, to me it's such a beautiful day to be able to just say you love Him. You know, I mean, we're at the end of 2017 and it's like, I feel good. And I'm grateful for that.